So One UI 7 beta is finally here, and I've got it running on my S24 Ultra. In this video, I'm breaking down 20 changes that make One UI 7 the biggest update we've seen in the history of One UI. Let's get right into it. What's up guys, Sal here. So first up, Samsung has finally added a vertical app drawer, a feature fans have been requesting for years. To enable it, tap the button at the bottom right corner next to the search bar. No need to dig into settings or good luck. But here's the catch, the vertical and horizontal layouts are tied to how the apps are sorted. When sorted alphabetically, the app drawer uses a vertical layout. But when using the custom sort option, in which you can move apps around as you see fit, it switches to the horizontal layout that you are accustomed to. Honestly, I'm thrilled this feature is here, but I hope future updates let us customize the vertical layout so frequently used apps can stay at the top. Thankfully though, the search bar is positioned at the bottom, making one-handed searches super convenient. A small but practical addition. The next big change is the nav bar. It's a subtle but functional tweak to the lock screen and always on display. If you're playing music for example, you'll see a little action bar at the bottom of the screen showing the song. Tap on it and the media player will pop up, giving you quick access to pause, skip or play. But it's not just for music, the nav bar works with other features too, like your stopwatch or other live notifications. But for some reason, it doesn't work on my build yet. Beta life, right? But they'll surely fix it in the final version. But yeah, nav bar isn't just for aesthetics, you can interact with it too. Samsung has also made changes to the battery protection. They're giving you even more control over your battery charging limits. In device care, you can now set a limit for how much your battery should charge. The option ranged from 80 to 95%, which helps prevent your battery from constantly charging to full, a setting that can extend its overall lifespan. Now, if you need to mute your phone temporarily, One UI 7 has a new temporary mute feature. This allows you to mute your phone for a specified amount of time, which is handy when you don't want to forget to turn your ringer back on. One of the most useful new additions is the automatic call transcription feature. Once you enable this in call settings, every recorded call is transcribed automatically, providing you with a written record of the conversation along with the voice recording. This means no need to replay long calls to find details, just search the transcription. Samsung has also upgraded its AI writing tools. For example, when you open a web page and select a piece of text, the screen will pop up the editing menu including the Galaxy AI icon at the start. Tap on that to open these 5 writing assist tools. The interface has also been visually revamped, and I have to admit, it gives off some serious iOS 18 vibes. Now let's talk about animations. Although this is still an early beta, you can already feel how much smoother it is compared to One UI 6.1. I'm not saying the animations before were bad, but the level of attention to detail in these small things really stand out. Like how the time and date subtly grow when you swipe the notification panel, or the soft pop-up effect of the home screen. There's the gradual reveal of the lock screen from the always-on display, the smooth movement of cards sliding left in the multitasking menu, and the seamless app transitions, opening and closing. Even the way the volume bar brightens as you turn up the music adds a nice touch. All these little changes make the UI look and feel way more fluid. You can really tell they've put a lot of work into this. Speaking of the multitasking menu, Samsung has given it a makeover. It now uses a stack style, something you could already do with Good Luck before, but now it's the default, and honestly, it's a big improvement over what we had before. It makes multitasking look cleaner and feel way more intuitive. They've also updated the notification panel. Now swiping down anywhere on the screen brings down just the notification panel, making it easier to access from any part of the device. If you want to get to the quick settings, there are two ways. Swipe from the top right corner or swipe left from the notification panel. The second option is perfect for one-handed use. The layout has been revamped too, with all the toggles now shown in a long list so you don't have to swipe through them. This makes it way quicker to access important settings. There's also a cool music player toggle which you can customize, plus you can bring down the toggles for easier one-handed access. Oh, and the notification cards now have a pill-shaped design with better spacing and improved contrast, making them look cleaner and more intuitive. you're not a fan of the new split layout for the notifications and quick settings, you can always switch back to the old layout where everything's on the same page. Speaking of pill-shaped design, the widgets have also gotten a refresh. Most of them are now pill-shaped, which fits perfectly with the overall design of the device. Samsung has added a blur effect to these widgets, making them blend smoothly with your home screen background while still being easy to read. They've also removed the borders around the stacked widgets, giving them a cleaner, more seamless look. Next, you can now resize app folders and make them bigger, making it easier to access your favorite apps. The battery icon has also been changed. It now displays a numerical percentage inside the icon itself, which is a pill shape. The font used for the time at the top of the screen has also been updated. The settings menu has received some subtle but important tweaks, with more rounded corners, clearer spacing, and improved contrast between sections. It feels way less cluttered. The overall design is much more organized and polished, making it easier to navigate. Some of the stock app icons, like those for the camera, gallery, calculator, internet, and more, have also been redesigned. Whether you're into the new look or not is totally up to you. Now onto the camera app. Samsung has made some serious changes here too. They've moved most of the controls to the bottom of the screen, which makes one-handed use much easier. They've also added a new level indicator to help you take perfectly straight shots, especially in portrait mode. It used to be a circle, but now it's a target symbol that you line up for a balanced shot. Plus, there's a new exposure control at the bottom, and the 2x zoom mode has been added to the zoom section. Another cool feature is the option to record videos while keeping the music player in the background, but you'll need to enable this in settings first. It's a small touch, but a nice one. In Pro mode, Samsung has revamped controls to make them more accessible. The new layout makes it much easier to adjust settings like ISO, shutter speed, and focus. Next, in the gallery, you now have a dedicated raw image editor setting. If you take a raw photo, you can edit it in a specialized editor that gives you more control over things like shadows and highlights before you move it into the standard editor for final tweaks. And here's another neat feature. You can now turn off the auto dimming feature when the battery drops below 5%. So if you want to keep your screen at full brightness, even when your battery is nearly empty, you can, even with the battery saver on. So all in all, One UI 7 has a lot going for it in terms of design, interaction, and features. The visual updates give a fresh and modern feel, while the interaction changes make the UI more fluid and customizable. Remember though, this is still a beta, so the final version, launching with the Galaxy S25 in January, will have even more features with a more polished experience. Speaking of which, here's the latest update on the S25. Click right here, and I'll see you there.